After this effervescent injuries, there is another important term which is asked for 5 mark for the exam. That is about healing of the bone fracture. Healing of the bone fracture. Right? So you have heard or you studied about how the healing takes place in case of wound. Rana is over now. So how the healing takes place? Healing of the wound? Or stages of healing? There are some stages or phases of healing. Like that only, here also there are some of the phases or stages of the healing of that particular bone fracture. So whenever there is a fracture, it should heal. Right? It should heal. So healing will take place in stages. Or we can say in phases. Right? Generally, the healing of a fracture bone is of three. One, first, it is related with the three R's. One R. The first phase of healing of the fracture of this bone is the phase of reaction. Phase of reaction. Right? Here there will be the reactionary phase. There is some sort of reactions going on just after the breaking up or discontinuity in the bone is there. Then there is some sort of reactions going on. It is the first phase is related with the reaction. In this reaction phase, again it is of two subphases. First phase is stage of hematoma formation. Right? There are generally three phases. Right? In the three phase, the first phase is stage of or the phase of reaction. In the first stage, there is another stage, that is stage of hematoma formation. So whenever there is a fracture, or discontinuity in the bone, right? It might be because of any causes. So whenever there is a fracture is there, at first phase of fracture what happens? There will be the stage of hematoma formation. Means the blood will rush in between the fracture segments or fracture fragments. Whenever there is a fracture, if there is a gapping in between the fracture, in between the bone, then what happens? There will be the collection of the blood. Right? It is called as stage of hematoma formation. After collection of this blood along with the exudates. Exudates means some sorts of secretions which are taking place or which are gathered in between the fractured segments of the bones. Right? There is some sorts of exudates or some sorts of secretions. Right? So these secretions along with the blood, it will make the first stage, that is stage of hematoma formation. Means here there will be a collection of blood. Along with the collection of blood, there is some sort of exudates or secretions which are related with the surrounding tissues, soft tissues. Or if there is injury to the soft tissue, all those tissues will secrete some sorts of secretions. Right? Those secretions might be containing the WBC cells, WBCs, or the RBCs, or different plasmas, or lymph fluid, any secretion. So all these secretions along with the blood, they will be collected in between the fracture segments. Here there is a fracture segment and here also there is a fracture segment. Consider this as a fracture. So if there is any fracture, right? If there is any fracture in between these things, what happens? There is a collection of the blood. So whenever there is a collection of blood in between the fractured segments, then what happens? It will fill the gap in between the fractured segments. So there is a gap, no? That gap will be filled by the secretions along with the blood. So all these secretions and the blood will come and accumulate in between the fracture segment or in between the gap. So this stage is called as stage of hematoma formation. As it is having the accumulation, the accumulated blood will be clotting. As it is coming out of its circuit, right? So what happens? There will be some sort of clotting. That clotted blood is called as hematoma. So this is the first stage wherein there will be the stage of hematoma, which hematoma will be formed. This is the first stage. This stage is in the reaction. Means here there is some sort of reaction which is occurred because of the fracture. So whenever there is a fracture, this is a reaction to that particular fracture. So it is in the reaction phase, and this is a stage of hematoma formation. So after this stage of hematoma formation, there is a second stage wherein there will be some sort of proliferation of the cells. Proliferation means proliferation. Pro means it is related with the professionalism or with the extra activity or with the extra knowledge or influence or whatever it is. It is some sort of extra. It is pro. Right? Liferation. Life means it is giving the life to the particular part of life. Fration means it is a process. So wherein there is some sort of extra growth. This is what is a proliferation. Right? So in the second part, what happens? There will be the stage of cellular proliferation. Cellular proliferation. Proliferation means what is? There will be some sorts of extracellular growths in between these cells. Right. So as this hematoma is formed just after the fracture. Right? Just after the fracture I have what happened? There is the hematoma. In that hematoma, there is some sort of changes. It is called as changes in between the cells or types of cells. It is called as metaphasia. Metaphasia means? Phasia means cells. It is related with the changes in cells. Or metaphasia means changes in the types of cells. These blood cells, these clotted blood cells or exudates will start slowly changing towards the chondroblasts. Chondroblast means chondroblast. Chondroblast. Chondro means chondra is the word which is related with the cartilage. Right? So chondra is the word related with the cartilage. Here, the hematogenic cells, which are clotted cells, or blood cells, or exudates, or the lymphatic fluids, all these cells will start slowly converting into chondroblasts. Right? So chondroblasts will be formed. This hematoma is converted into the chondroblasts, or there will be the changes in the cells. It is called as metaphasia. Right? Metaphasia means changes from one type of cell to the another type. It is metaphasia. So here what happens, the hematogenic cells or the blood cells or the exudates is changing into the chondrocytes or the chondroblasts. Blasts, generally the blast word is used for the growth cells, which are having the growth mode or which are having the capacity to regrow or which are having the capacity to grow the other cells or called as blasts. Right? Osteoblasts means the osteoblasts are the cells which are having the capacity to regrow or to give the birth to the new cells. Right? So those are called as blasts. Right? Erythroblasts. Erythroblasts means those which are giving the blood cells or erythrocytes or the RBCs growing cells. Erythropoietic. So blastic means they are giving birth to the new ones. Right? So here the chondroblast means the chondra will be formed. Means there should be the formation of this cartilage structure in between this or conversion of, after conversion of this hematogenic cells or blood cells. They will be converted into the cartilage cells. Right? So whenever this stage is called, this is the stage of second stage, that is the stage of cellular proliferation. Means new cells are growing. This is also in the phase of reaction. Right? In the second phase, there is a phase of repair. Right? This is the second stage. The stage of repair. Means repairing of the cells will take place. Right? Repairing of the cells will take place in this phase. Here what happens? There is a stage of, again two stages here also, callus formation. Callus formation means callus is one of the hard tissue or newly formed tissue, right? Callus means it is the hard tissue or newly formed tissue which is related with the osteoblasts or osteogenes or osteocytes, right? Means, osteo means it is the word related with the bone. So new bone cells are formed in this case. The callus means the stage of new bones, right? New bone tissue or new bone cells. Here, in this way what happens, there will be the repair. Repair, how it is repairing? These cellular blood cells. So all these are the conversion from starting with the blood to in the osteoblasts, right? So blood is converted into some sort of new cells, that is chondroblast. After this chondroblast, this is the next stage, is the osteoblast. So this system, which is having the fibrils or fibers in between, the fibers of the chondra or the cartilage, the fibers of the bones, all these in the new stages, it is called as the herbaceous system. This formation of this system is called as herbaceous system. Herbaceous system is H-E-R-B-A-C-E-O-U-S. Herbaceous system means what it is? It is the newly formed cells or not complete adult bone cells. It is new cells of the bones, right? Wherein they will going to form the adult bone cells. So those are, those system of the cells or a combination of different cells are called as herbaceous system, right? So here we are saying the callus formation. Callus means what it is? It is the new bone tissue which is formed. It is called as callus, right? So stage of callus formation, here what happens, there will be formation of callus, means generally the chondroblasts are converting into the osteoblasts, right? The bone cells are forming. This is the stage. Here in this callus formation stage, again there are three different stages, that is internal callus, external callus and the intermediate callus. There are again three phases, that is internal callus, external callus and the intermediate callus. Callus is formed. How the callus is formed? In between, in the three stages. Externally also there will be formation of callus. Internally also there will be formation of this callus. And in between the external and internal layers, there is again callus formation. Right? Externally means on the outer layer of the bone, on the particular bone, there will be formation of, or gapping will be filled. Means how the gapping will be filled? It is filled by the, again, new cells, new osteoblasts. Right, they will be filling externally in the particle level. Internal callus formation means internally what will be there? In the long bones, definitely in the long bones, there will be the bone marrow. In the adults, there will be the bone marrow. Right? Which bone marrow it is? Generally, it is of yellow bone marrow. Right? So this yellow bone marrow will be replaced with the this internal callus. Right? The yellow bone marrow will be replaced with the internal callus. As there is no gap, yes, there is no any between. Because of the fracture, there is a gap. That gap is filled by the hematoma. That hematoma will be filled by this callus. Internally, in the internal part, in the hollow part of that bone, there will be the formation of this callus, internal callus, which is replacing, which will be replacing the yellow bone marrow in case of organisms. Right? So intermediate callus means it is the callus which is present on the spongy part of the bone. Or the callus part of the bone, right? That the callus part of the bone will be filled by this intermediate callus. And also the externally, external callus will be filled with the cortical bone tissue, right? That will be filled. It is called as external callus. So this is the stage of callus formation. After this stage of callus formation, there is new bone tissue formation. Actually, the callus is also the new bone, but the adult bones or adult bone cells will be formed in the next stage, after the stage of callus formation. Right? This is also in the stage of repair. Right? So after this repair, the third phase or the last phase is the stage of remodeling. The remodeling. Remodeling is reshaping of a particular bone, fractured bone. How it is? Generally in case of the children, what happens? If there is any angular deformity, while joining of the bones, fracture segments, if there is any angular deformity, that angular deformity will be replaced, or that angular deformity which has been formed, that will be remolded or reshaped into the normal one to make it in the normal alignment. Right? So the normal alignment will be formed in this stage, that is in this phase, that is the phase of remodeling. Means extra cells which are having the callus will be formed, external callus will be replaced with the normal tissue, extra bony tissues will be there, the callus will be replaced, it will be remolded. In case of children, the axial rotation, if there is any present, So that axial rotation will also be remolded out. It will be in the alignment if there is axial rotation. But in case of adults, the axial rotation will not be replaced, will not be remolded or reshaped. It will remain as it is. The axial rotation, if there is present in case of adults in the fracture, it will not be remolded or reshaped. Only the angular deformity will be reshaped or normalized in case of adults. Whereas in children, the axial rotation is also reshaped or remolded along with the angular deformity. If there is any angular deformity, that deformity will also be replaced or normalized. If there is any axial deformity, that deformity is also normalized in case of children, means as they are in the growth phase. But in case of adults, only the angular deformity will be replaced by the stage of remolding, not by the phase of remolding. We have the remolding. And internal callus, what I said, it will be replaced with generally the soft adipose tissue, which will going to be the yellow bone marrow. The internal callus will be replaced with the period of remolding. What happens? The internal callus which is formed, it will be replaced in the adipose tissue. Adipose tissue will be there. After that, adipose tissue will be converted into the yellow bone marrow. Right? So these are the three phases of healing of the fractured bone. Right? It can be studied in three phases or in five stages. Right? The first stage is stage of amalgam formation. Second stage is the stage of cellular proliferation. The third stage is the stage of callus formation. Fourth is the stage of new bone generation or new bone formation. And the fifth is the remolding stage. If we are saying that it is having three phases, then it will be of